Hi, it's Brian from iSpring, and today we're going to find out how to design a professional-looking course in PowerPoint. Before we get started, I'd like to acknowledge the fact that not everybody has time to slave over the perfect design for a course, so that's why iSpring provides professional-looking slide templates right here in the content library. You can start by selecting from several smooth, sleek, suave styles, including standard courses and dialogue scenarios. Now let's close out of here and take a closer look at some of the elements that make these templates work. One of the first things you'll notice is that there's a consistent color scheme across the entire course. There's a general light style to it, and where there isn't a photographic background, it's simply white. Also, the buttons and lines are a consistent green color. You can also go to the Design tab and pick from a built-in PowerPoint theme, or at least take some notes from what they've done as well. By the way, one trick you can use to keep color consistency is to right-click a shape and use the eyedropper tool to grab that color. Now it's in your recent colors list, and you can apply it to new objects that you add. The next thing is to choose a good font. You can make your course look really professional or give it a more relaxed feel. You don't want to go too crazy, but don't be afraid to experiment. A study has shown that even quirky fonts like the dreaded Comic Sans can help improve reading retention. See the link in the description below. Whatever font you do choose, though, you should keep it consistent throughout the course. You might have slightly different fonts for titles and headers, but don't go too nuts. Let's look at one more trick involving fonts. Go up to File, Options, Save, and check this option to embed all the fonts in the presentation so it will maintain consistency across computers. Select the second option here if you plan to edit it on another computer or share it with colleagues for editing. Okay, now the final piece of advice I have for you today is to make sure to align all your objects nicely. This may seem obvious, but it's important to remember nevertheless. As you can see, PowerPoint has some auto guides, but those may be a little squirrely, so you may want to right-click and use some guides or grid lines and snap objects to the grid. The ruler can also come in handy if you want to space objects evenly on the slides. Well, that's about all I have to share with you today. Obviously, these are just the basics and will probably be obvious to many of you pros out there, but they're worth repeating. And don't forget, if you don't have the time, or just don't feel like slaving over course design, feel free to use one of these professionally designed templates from the iSpring content library. Thanks for watching. Now you know how to design a professional-looking course in PowerPoint. Did you like this video? Give it a like and subscribe to the iSpring YouTube channel for more updates.